Hello, it's Maria from the River Forest Public Library back again with another craft tutorial. This week we're going to be making these coffee filter butterflies. I bet you have almost everything needed to complete this project within your house. These coffee filter butterflies are super easy to do and I love the watercolor tie-dye effect that they have. This project will take no time at all, so let's go ahead and get started. For this project you will need coffee filters, a clothespin, markers, a pipe cleaner, a spray bottle with water, and an easy wipe surface. For this, I'm using a plastic bag. So each coffee filter butterfly is made up of two coffee filters, a clothespin, and a pipe cleaner. The first step of the project is to create the coffee filter wings. To create the wings, all you need to do is grab two coffee filters, lay them flat down, and then taking your markers, all you have to do is draw a design on one side of the filter. I've been making both filters similar so that my wings are symmetrical, but you don't need to do that. It's totally up to you. So go ahead and pick a few colors. I'm gonna make a blue-green butterfly. And once you've picked out your colors, go ahead and start drawing on the coffee filter. Once you spray the coffee filter with the water, it's going to start bleeding together and creating this watercolor effect. So it doesn't need to be perfect at all. Just go ahead and slap some color down wherever you would like. Once you've completed one coffee filter, go ahead and complete the next. All right, so both of our coffee filters have been drawn on. As you can see, I've matched both coffee filters in terms of design. And as you can see, there's actually quite a bit of white space on the coffee filter. That is totally fine. That will allow the colors to bleed in together a little bit more cleanly instead of muddying it up. All right, so now onto the fun part. Go ahead and take your first dry coffee filter, lay it down on your surface that you can easily wipe up afterwards. For this, I'm gonna use a plastic bag. Take your spray bottle with water and just go ahead and start spraying down. You wanna make sure that your coffee filter is definitely soaked through. And right off the bat, you can actually see the colors start bleeding in together. Just spray it down, and once it's soaked through, go ahead and lift it from your plastic bag and set it aside to fully dry. Between each spray down, I like to wipe the plastic bag clean. Once the plastic bag is dry again, it's time to spray down your second coffee filter. So just lay it flat, take your spray bottle, and spray away. And you're done with that component. So go ahead and take the second coffee filter and find a place to set it aside and dry. It should only take about 5 minutes for it to dry. All right, so our paper filter is fully dry at this point in time, and now it's time to fold them. Go ahead and start making accordion style folds, like you would with a fan, and go ahead and make it all the way down. You want these folds to be pretty tight. I'm making mine about 1 inch thick. These folds are gonna bring texture to the butterfly wings, so you're welcome to make it as thick or thin as you would like. And you should end up with something like this. Once you're done folding it, go ahead and set it aside and start with the other one. And do the same thing with the second one. So both filters have been folded. All you have to do is stack them right on top of each other. Once you have them stacked together, go ahead and take your clip and clip it on. I like to have the clothespin going vertical and the wings going horizontal because it kind of looks like the body of the butterfly. So now that you have the pin on, go ahead and fan out your butterfly wings. To do that, all you need to do is grab each section and gently pull them apart. And as you can see, as we pull them apart, you can see the beautiful tie-dye and watercolor effect. Once you're done fanning the wings out, go ahead and set it aside and then form the antennas of the butterfly. For the antennas, we're just gonna use one pipe cleaner color of your choosing. Go ahead and fold it in half. So that makes a V. And then at the top, go ahead and curl in the ends of the pipe cleaner. And there we have it, that's the antenna. To assemble, all you have to do is open up the pin and stick the antenna in. The pin is gonna hold everything in place. And there you go, your butterfly is complete. You can always color in the body of the butterfly if you don't like the natural wood look, but I'm digging it, so I'm gonna go ahead and leave it here. I hope you give this project a try, and if you do, let us know how it goes. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you guys later. Bye!